Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine. I'm keeping well too. So today we are going to learn the chapter Quality, written by John Galsworthy. Okay. So this is a story written by Galsworthy in the year 1912 about a German shoemaker, whose name is Chesler Brothers. The story starts with the description of the shop, that is the boot shop, that there is a small and only nameplate of the Chesler Brothers, okay? And only a few shoes would have been kept at the rack in the window neck. The brothers would make the shoes only on orders. Whenever they got orders, the brothers used to make shoes, okay? And they never used to, keep the shoes prepared or anything, and they made it all by their own hands. Okay, they never used anyone or they never hired anyone to make the shoes. Okay, so now the reading of the chapter will help us to know the chapter in a better way. So while reading the chapter, we'll see what happens in the next ones. Okay. So before that, let's see to it. As I told you, we are going to read the chapter Quality, which is written by John Galsworthy. It's very important to know about the poet or the writer. John Galsworthy was an English playwright and a story writer, and he wrote basically everything in a very lucid way, in a very easy way he wrote. And he wrote this story Quality, keeping in mind some particular points. The theme of the story we can go about with is commitment, determination, loyalty towards one's own work and passion, honesty, dedication, and the final loss that we find at the end of the story, that is not knowing the business strategies or lacking the business strategies like any other businessman. And therefore, it leads to the final death of the main protagonist or the main character of the play, who is Mr. Chesler. So we'll find throughout the story about the commitment of a shoemaker, the determination of a shoemaker, the loyalty towards his own work and passion that he puts into, his honesty towards his work, his dedication to his work, and finally what he receives out of all these things. Once you don't know about business rules, business strategies, you don't know how to negotiate with people, keeping in mind that you have to earn money, you are only dedicated, you are only committed to your work, will only lead to your final destruction or your final loss or your final death. So let's see what the story tells us. And I'll be going on telling you the meaning of the words that you find difficult in the story. So everyone look at the book and see what the story has to tell us. You see, the very story starts with, can a shoemaker be called an artist? Artist here refers to, a person who is very skilled at any work. Yes, if he has the same skill and pride of his trade, trade here refers to business, as any other artist. So yes, you are an artist if you have all the skills, if you have everything in you in order to excel at your work or art, then definitely you are an artist, because artists are basically known for, music, that is singing, dancing, painting. They are known as artists because it requires the caliber of art, right? So that's why they are known as artists. So that's the very first question that strikes your head, that can a shoemaker be called an artist? So as we read the chapter, we'll come to know what a great artist this shoemaker, Mr. Jessler, was. Yes, if he has the same skill and pride in his trade as any other artist. So if he has in himself that zeal, that business, the art in himself, then he's a great artist. And the same respect for it too. So an artist must have the same respect for his skill or art. Otherwise, he will never excel in his artistic work. Mr. Jessler, who is the main protagonist of the story, you see the main character, who is a German shoemaker who settled in London. So here we find that Mr. Jessler is a German shoemaker. And once we start reading the chapter, you will find that, in his very accent, the way he speaks and everything, you will find that he has the colloquial native accent of that of a German person. So he has finally settled in London and is a perfect artist. So we find in him all the artistic qualities of a perfect artist. Read the story to see how he devotes his life to his art. So devotes means how he delivers, how he gives his entire life for his artistic work. He gives his life, he devotes his life, he submits his life, he was submissive to his art in performing the art of making a shoe. Okay. So let's start reading the chapter. The very first line, quality, as I told you, the very theme or the very, the very commitment that we find in the story is quality. Mr. Jessler only devotes his time and passion for the quality of the shoe. He doesn't think of money. He doesn't think of how much time it will take. He dedicates his entire soul and time and dedication only for making a pair of shoe. And he doesn't even let anyone touch the shoe while making. He makes it a point that each and everything is made by his own hands, and he has made it himself, so that he can look up at the quality. He can look up at the quality of the shoe. I knew him. I here refers to the narrator. So we find that the narrator knew him for a long time. How? I knew him from the days of my extreme youth. Extreme youth refers to from his very childhood. How he knows him from his very childhood? Because he made my father's boots. So he was a person who used to make my father's boot. So from the legacy of my father, I know him from my very childhood. He lived with his elder brother in shop, which was in a small by street in a fashionable part of London. So he lived in the shop itself with his brother. We are talking about Mr. Jessler, who used to live with his elder brother in the shop itself, which was at a small by street in a fashionable part of London. The shop had a certain quiet distinction. So the shop had a certain quiet distinction refers to, it was some sort of different from the other shops that was located nearby. That we are going to see how is it distinct or different from the other shops. There was no sign upon it other than the name of Jessler Brothers. So the shop only had the name Jessler Brother as a signboard. And in the window, a few pairs of boots. So on the rack of the window, there were only few pairs of boots. It was not that the entire shiny boots, polished and everything, was kept on the rack, unlike the other, we find shoe shops these days. They did not showcase all the shoes over there, but a few were broadcasted and were shown on the racks of the shoe shop. The shop had a certain quiet distinction. There was no sign upon it other than the name of Jessler Brothers. And in the window, a few pairs of boots. He made only what was ordered. As I told you, He only made what was ordered to make. Like, he did not make the things beforehand, or he did not keep the shoes from many days. He made the shoes once the order was made. And what he made never felt to feet. So he was so particular, he was so neat and tidy in his work that once he made the shoes, you know, he never failed to fit in the legs or in the leg. He was perfect in his shape and fittings of the shoes. So whoever would wear this shoe would be very comfortable in the particular pair of shoes. So he was very particular about the size and mending of the shoes. He made only what was ordered, and what he made never fell to feet. So the fittings was perfect, whoever wore the shoes. To make boots, such boots as he made, seemed to me then and still seems to me mysterious and wonderful. So it still seems to me that the way he makes shoes was a kind of mystery, you know, thing of wonder for me. I still wonder how he made the shoes, and it was so nice in fitting, and the fitting was so good, and moreover, you know, the size and everything was so perfect, it was so comfortable that he could not even think of anyone else to prepare or make or mend the shoes, you know. I remember well my shy remarks one day while stretching out to him my youthful foot. So I remember well my shy remarks, you know. He said something which made himself shy, you know. He was shy to make such a remark one day while stretching out to him my youthful foot. That is, his feet was very, you know, young, because he was of a youthful character. He was at his tender age, at his young age. And stretching out means handing over the his feet to the shoemaker, right, Mr. Jessler. Isn't it awfully hard to do, Mr. Jessler? So even I was surprised how he made such a shoe. So I asked him, isn't it very hard to, you know, make such shoes in such a way? And his answer, given with a sudden smile from out of the redness of his beard, it is an art. You see, as I told you, he was a German man, so his accent and everything was different. So it is said, it is an art. So it means that it is an art to make a shoe. So it's you know, it's very difficult, or it takes time to make any shoe. And why is it said that sudden smile out of his redness? Because he was so fair in complexion that, you know, the shine was red and everything. So he used to shine out of being fair in complexion. I think that will be all for today's session. We'll continue from the next day, from the next paragraph. Thank you so much. And kindly read the chapter well, and do let me know if you have any doubt while reading the chapter. We are only done with the first two paragraphs of the chapter, quality. Okay? Thank you so much.